give a thought about a situation where you are in such a state where sky outside is ruddy yellow brown, or imagine the foggiest day of your life and you badly need an escape, or you are in a vacation with your loved one in Maldives and your boss calls out for an emergency meeting. Think about all the additional lockdown situation due to COVID-19 pandemic. How to sort all these unusual yet regular issues? Any idea? Well, I'll surely make it easy for you. Introducing you to the Oculus Quest 2, which is truly a savior from all of that. It improves on almost everything from the authenticity at a more affordable price, making it the best VR headset for both newbies and experienced users. It's surely smaller than its original Quest, a little lighter, which is quite impressive considering the displays are amazing than ever before. It does not feel heavy like the previous stuff, which felt like binoculars on the face. Fabric is what they have chosen this time for their outer portion instead of the semi-rigid soft touch plastic. The best part is technically you do not need a controller because no cables are required for the usage. Sharp display, powerful processor, motion tracking accuracy, and an optional PC tethering, which with an accessory cable are the basic features of this mind-boggling gadget. The coolest thing of all is the cost. Well, you won't believe that you just gotta spend $299 for this gear, a full $100 less than the original Quest, and significantly much lower than the $699 HTC Vive cost now. And now comes the actual part. How it is ruling at the virtual reality zone. Recently, Mark Zuckerberg took this initiative to invest in virtual reality and dominate in this arena. The gear he brought on this market is truly admirable. The new Oculus Quest 2 is positioned as one of the best options for virtual reality. The first version of Oculus Quest arrived in September 2018, just 2 years ago. Among its characteristics was that it did not require a cable connection to the computer. In other words, it was totally independent virtual reality glasses, with what it means in design and comfort. The Oculus Quest 2 follows the idea with an update on specifications and some polished details. Facebook claimed that the second version of the Oculus Quest could improve to another level, and they proved it right. When it comes to focusing on the screen, Oculus has placed a resolution of 1832 into 192 pixel per eye instead of the 1440 to 1600 pixels per eye for the original model. Although we will have a more notable change, the refresh rate, which becomes 90 Hz, the refresh rate will come as an update. Initially, it will be 72 Hz. An extremely important extra feature that Oculus Quest 2 incorporates is the link USB-C cable. This cable is sold as a separate accessory for $79 and allows you to connect to a device to a PC to play virtual reality games on your desktop. It is a feature that was already beta tested on original Oculus Quest. It is now an official feature. With this, the Oculus Quest 2 also replaces the Rift S, which essentially depended on connecting to the computer. Facebook claims that virtual reality glasses can provide social experiences as well. A linked account allows Oculus users to find Facebook friends in virtual reality. And they recently created a virtual version of Facebook in which you can interact with friends. Facebook has announced the security and privacy measures that it has implemented on the platform. They included recording everything that happened to the avatars, that is to us, the users, and relationship with the universe. According to Facebook, one of the big problems with virtual reality so far has been the difficulty in submitting reports about problematic events. They claim that they know it's difficult to record a painful incident when it's happening, which is why your Oculus headset will capture the last minutes of your horizon experience on an ongoing basis. In this way, Facebook argues, when the user reports negative behaviors, they manage to capture the information that later can be used as evidence. They have also explained the information that is captured is recorded in a continuous buffer on the device and is overwritten from time to time. Additionally, they ensure that captured audio data is not stored on servers unless a report is uploaded for review by moderators. However, Facebook also explains that if you are silent or you block or report a problem with someone, a trained specialist who will not appear as an avatar could remotely observe and record the situation to ensure the safety. Facebook Horizon has a safe zone, access from a tool on the wrist where users can block others, report problems, and silence them. It is a way to protect yourself from the problems that generate anxiety or discomfort or simply to rest. Mark Zuckerberg seems to be a great believer in the perspective of virtual reality. He stated several times that, according to him, VR would replace mobile as the next revolutionary computing platform very soon. In March 2020, Facebook revealed that sales on VR content have already crossed $100 million over the past few years. That implies every VR owner has spent around $140 on the VR content for their $400 to $500 headsets. Launching Oculus Quest 2 has directly eliminated this cost to around 30 to 40%. This builds up a huge difference, and comparison has actually no space regarding Oculus Quest 2 with any other VR device. These are just fragments of Facebook's outcome for now. Zuckerberg is highly into the mission to gain ultimate success for Facebook to dominate VR truly.